Hey friends, if you use Azure Load Balancer, did you know that you now have instant access to a packaged solution for health monitoring and configuration analysis? Azure Monitor for Networks provides this new monitoring and insights experience for Azure Load Balancer. Eric's here to show me how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm going to learn today all about Azure Insights and how I can use it to monitor my Azure Load Balancer. I'm here with Eric Robinson-Tillenberg, who's going to teach me that. How are you, sir?
Hey Scott, I'm doing great. Happy to be here. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, fantastic. You know, I was thinking about this and I realized that, do you think that pretty much anything in Azure of any size eventually has a load balancer in front of it?
Absolutely. And whether that's a layer 4 load balancer like we're talking about here or a layer 7 load balancer like Application Gateway, any scalable cloud application needs to have a load balancer in order to take advantage of the number of compute resources that you're deploying. So, I would say that almost any application of scale has a load balancer in it.
So these load balancers, you know, I honestly don't think about them that much. It might be because I'm kind of a small business, you know, my blog and stuff like that. But if I was a big business, I would probably have a lot of load balancers. I'd have a lot of routes. Like, what kind of things do I need to know other than it's working and it's not working?
Absolutely. If you have many different load balancers configured, you need to, at a quick glance, to know, like you said, whether it's working or not working. And so that means whether or not the rules that you have configured are balancing traffic the way that you thought they were going to, whether or not the compute resources in the back end of your load balancer are accessible. So say you have some web servers behind a load balancer, you need to make sure that those web servers are healthy and are receiving traffic. Then you might need to know how much traffic is flowing through that load balancer so that you can get an idea of how much load is being placed on your application so that you can make decisions whether or not to scale in or scale out your compute resources.
So where would I go looking for this before? Because I understand that having these new insights into the load balancer is going to unlock a bunch of insights and metrics that I guess, were they invisible before? I couldn't even see them?
Yeah, so before it was all a manual process. So we have a robust set of metrics for a load balancer. But as you see here, you need to configure and aggregate, select which metrics you want, select how you want to aggregate them, filter and split them according to what you're looking to achieve, and then create your own custom dashboard from there. And so before, in order to monitor a load balancer in Azure, it required significant background knowledge and a decent amount of time to get up to speed in creating your own dashboard, figuring out what metrics were relevant to what questions. And so we decided with the insights to abstract all that away from the customer, or at least give them a head start by pre-configuring a large number of metrics that answer the most common questions that customers have regarding their load balancer.
Okay, this makes a lot of sense to me. So the rich metrics have always existed, but it was on me to figure out what insights I were to glean from that. So now you've taken that base of all those metrics and layered a new level of insight. So now I can ask, you know, educated questions about my load balancer and my configuration.
That's just right, Scott. So it's all pre-configured out of the box. You don't need to set anything up yourself. And in addition to that, we've layered on top of that, we've added a functional dependency view of your load balancer. So with many of these complex cloud applications, customers are deploying load balancers with many different rules, going to many different backend pools, and it can be quite difficult to keep a record of where everything is, simply by, say, pulling it through PowerShell or CLI or viewing component by component in the portal. And what we've done here is we've given you a visual of the functional dependencies of your load balancers so that you can make informed design decisions at any time. So in this case, in this example, I've got two websites that I've connected with my load balancer. and I've set up on website A, I've set it up for HTTP and HTTPS, but I can quickly at a glance see that I've forgotten to set up a rule for HTTPS for website B. So Scott, for your load balancers that are running all of your personal websites, you can easily take a quick look at what the setup, what the last configuration you had set up, and then make any updates that you need to from there.
This is a gorgeous, gorgeous page. Like any page that shows you that 20,000 foot view is so fundamentally different from what we saw before. With the metrics, I can design my own charts and graphs. It's almost like Excel, where it's just a stream of numbers that I can then put visualizations on top of. But you've got some really sophisticated visualizations here that give me immediately a snapshot view of what's going on. I can tell a lot of information just by looking at this.
Absolutely. We have your key metrics for your load balancer here, the time-wise graph of your health probe status. You can see here that we've got color-coded lines going to your compute resources to represent their health. So if your web server hosting one of your personal websites it goes down, you'll immediately be able to see at a glance that that's red. Now, like you had alluded to before, there are more things than just is it working? Is it not working? Are my backend resources functional? And in order to provide you with that view as well, we've created this more detailed metrics dashboard to answer most common questions you may have regarding your load balancer.
All right, let's see it.
Yeah, I'll pull it up right here. So we've got our overview page. At a glance, you can quickly see your load balancer status. You can see that there's no platform issues impacting this load balancer. We've got some nice useful docs here. So if you have a question about your load balancer, you can quickly get redirected there. If you need to learn more about what these metrics are, you can get an in-depth guide here. You can quickly see the data throughput that you have going through this load balancer. So this may be something you want to monitor to ensure that you have steady traffic flowing through the load balancer, or that you have enough compute resources to serve the traffic that's been flowing through. You can quickly see for all the front-end IPs or websites that you have connected with your load balancer, their overall data availability and health probe status. From there, if you find any discrepancies with your data availability or health probe status, the help section will redirect you to our front end and back end availability tab, where you can get an even more in-depth view of what the availability of your load balancer is. So in this case, it's not very interesting because we've got a healthy load balancer here, so everything's at 100. So I'll quickly take us over to an unhealthy load balancer that I've created, where I've forgotten on my web server to set it up for HTTPS. So I have no certs set up on my web server, and it's failing the HTTPS health probe I set up. But for HTTP, it's working fine. So over port 80, I can scroll down here, and I can see that over port 80, I've got 100% health probe status. So that those web servers on port 80 are returning a HTTP 200 OK to all of the probes. But then we can see here that we've got an issue with port 443 on both our back end as well as our front end. So we know that there's an issue with that's related to HTTPS with our back end instances. And we can go from here to then diagnose and resolve that problem.
Oh, okay.
So I'll take us right back to the previous dashboard, and we can, at a glance, look at the overall data throughput over time. And a lot of customers, if you've got a load balancer deployed, Scott, you'll want to know how your load balancer is actually distributing traffic. So is your load balancer actually doing its job in distributing the load?
Exactly.
So you can quickly navigate over to this flow distribution tab, where you can see how many inbound and outbound flows are being created for each backend instance and the total network traffic that's going to those. So you can see here, if you've got, say you've configured session affinity on your load balancer, where it's only using the source IP address to route traffic, and you have a large number of requests coming from the same source IP, You'll quickly be able to see here that one of your backend servers is receiving a significant number of flows relative to the other and have an instant view of any performance impacting issues with regards to your flow distribution. So we split it up by your VM scale sets as well as your VMs. I'm sorry about that. So that we can get a quick glance of for all of your compute resources.
There is so much information here. This is just fantastic. Like this is, again, using those underlying metrics. Like the data has always been there, but it's just never been this easy, this accessible, this pretty, and organized in this clean workbook like this.
Absolutely. And what we found was that a majority of our customers have similar questions with regards to their load balancers. There aren't that many sort of edge cases when it comes to what you want to know about your load balancer. However, I mean, you can see scrolling through here that there's a ton of information and that it's very easy to get overloaded. And that's the case even if you configure your own custom dashboard and share it with a coworker for a project that you're working on. And we decided we could mitigate that by giving you some nice helpful guidance here so that if you're ever feeling overwhelmed, you can simply scroll to the bottom of the page and have a nice walkthrough on how to interpret these dashboards.
Yeah, this workbook style of metrics is just so nice.
Yeah, absolutely. And of course, this is something whereby you can make a copy of this, Scott, edit it. Say you want to add new metrics. There are other insights that you want to derive that are specific to your website. You can go here, edit it, make a copy, and save it somewhere so that we've given you a sort of a playground to start your own custom insights.
That's fantastic.
I'll finish here on the metrics dashboard with our connections monitor page, where you're able to see the latency to your load balance, the round trip latency to your load balancer from regions around the world. So you'll see here that I've got a virtual machine in North Europe, Korea, and West US 2 that are all pinging the front end of my load balancer and reporting the various latencies. So my load balancer is deployed in West US 2, so you can see that this is the speed of light does impact the performance of your load balancer.
It absolutely does.
So that's So what we've tried to do here is aggregate the metrics from all of the resources related to your load balancer. So before you might have to go to the metrics for your virtual machine to see the total network traffic is for each of your virtual machines. You might have to go to a different connection monitor page in order to see what the latency to the front end IP of your load balancer is. And with this dashboard, we've decided to aggregate all of those in one place so that we can address a lot of the common questions that customers have.
That's fantastic.
I'll finish off by showing you how you can not only access this through the load balancer, the blade of your load balancer, but you can also access this from the Azure Monitor for Networks Hub, where you can navigate to your monitor blade, and then under Insights, you can navigate to Networks, where you'll then see the overall health status of all your network resources, from your load balancers to your application gateways, firewalls, and more. So you can quickly, like Scott, you were telling me before that you're running a large number of personal websites. And if you've got a load balancer deployed for each one of those, you can go to the central place and just take a quick glance to make sure everything's healthy. If you find something's degraded, quickly navigate to the metrics dashboard from there.
That is pure money. So we have this already, right? Do I have this? This is in preview, but do I have to click anything or do I just go to the blade and I'll find it today?
Definitely. So this feature is in preview, but it's available right now. So if you go to any of your load balancers, navigate to that Insights blade, you'll have a pre-configured metrics dashboard and a functional dependency graph of your load balancer right there ready for you.
Oh, I love it. I love it when I have a feature and I didn't even know I had a feature, and all I have to do is stop watching Azure Friday and go and turn it on right away.
Absolutely. We love to give people nice surprises.
Fantastic. Well, I am learning all about how to use Azure Insights to monitor my Azure load balancer today on Azure Friday. Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.